It's a pleasure coming here to come and rehearse the little thing that you've taught us. So we ask Allah to guide us on what we're about to say. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul 'uqdata min lisani yafqahu qawli. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah wa ashhadu anna sayyidina wa sanidina Muhammad abduhu wa rasuluh. We give our praises to Allah Azza wa Jalla, who has made it possible for us to see 2/3 of Ramadan behind us, inshallah. We ask Allah to count us among those that would have their Ramadan accepted. May Allah forgive our excesses, our sins, overlook our mistakes, and grant us the best of this world and hereafter. For those that started Ramadan with us that are no longer here, may Allah forgive them. For those that are sick, may Allah grant them shifa. For those that are hoping that one day they will be able to fast like us, may Allah give them a speedy recovery. Ameen. And for all of us that are fasting, may Allah grant us the certificate of paradise. Ameen. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his household members, and all those that were instrumental in our lives, our parents, our teachers. Ameen. To the day of judgment. I'm glad to be here before you to talk about Sifatul Mu'min, which is the qualities of the believer, or you can say Akhlaqul Mu'minun, or you can say the manners of those that are the true believers. It's quite an opportunity and a blessing at the same time that Allah has given us the opportunity and the ability to grow in faith. If we look in the seerah of the Prophet, you would see a very famous hadith that talks about the three stages of faith that we Muslims can aspire to attain. And these hadith was recorded by Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu. He said that we were sitting with Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam one day. Then approached us was a man in a pure white clothing, and his hair was shiny dark, with no traces of him coming from a journey. And none of us knew him or we know of him until he sat with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and his knees were touching that of the Prophet, to the point whereby his palms were placed on the thighs of the Prophet. Then he said, Ya Muhammad, Ahbirni an al-Islam. O Muhammad, tell me, give me a news of what Islam is all about. Prophet then said, to testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. He said, there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Azza wa Jalla. And also to testify that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the messenger of Allah. Number three, to uphold the five daily prayers. Number four, to pay the due rights of the poor, which is zakah. And number five is to fast the month of Ramadan. And number six is to go to Hajj if you have the means, at least once in a lifetime. Then he said, Sadaqta, you've spoken the truth. Those that were with the Prophet at that point in time, including Sayyidina Umar, they were amazed at the manner of the questioning and also the affirmation or confirmation to the responses to the question. Then he says, Ahbirni an al-Iman. So give me a good news, or give me the news about Iman, which is belief. Then he said, to continuously believe in Allah and his angels and his books and his messenger and the day of judgment, and to believe in predestiny, the good of it and the bad of it. Khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah ta'ala, they are both from Allah. Then he said, you've spoken the truth, Sadaqta. Then he said, give me the news about Ihsan, which is excellence. So we go from Islam to Iman to Ihsan. May Allah make us of those that will be Muhsinin or Muhsinat. Ameen. So tell me about excellence in conduct. Then he said, Anta abudallah ka'annaka tara, fa in lam takun tara, fa innahu yaraka. He says, it is to worship Allah as if you see him. And if you have no ability to see Allah, know that he sees you and I as we worship him. Then he says, give me the news about the day of judgment. The Prophet ﷺ responded that the questioner knows better than the one being questioned on the matter. Then he said, give me the news about the signs of the coming of the day of judgment. The Prophet ﷺ says, when the woman will give birth to her master, when you see the shepherds from the desert competing in building massive skyscrapers. After the questioner left, then the Prophet says, O Umar, radiallahu anhu, do you know the questioner? He said, Allah and the Prophet knows best. He said, that was Jibril that came to teach you your religion. Innahu Jibril atakum yu'allimakum dinakum. That was Jibril that came to teach your religion in the best form. And this was narrated by Imam Muslim, rahimahullah. So to corroborate what we just learned from the hadith of the Prophet with what Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran about the believers, the first stop would be in Surah Al-Baqarah, Quran chapter 2, verse 285, when Allah says, Aman al-Rasul bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihi wal-mu'minun. Kullun amana billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusuli. La nufarriku bayna ahadi min rusul. Wa qalu sami'na wa a'tana gufranaka rabbana wa ilayka al-masir. Allah says, amana al-rasul bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihi. The messengers and the messenger that was sent, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, believed in what he was sent down with from his Lord. Bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihim, what he was sent down with from his Lord, wal mu'minun, and so do the believers. As the Prophet ﷺ believes in Allah and the message, so should the believers believe in Allah and the message. Kullun amana billah, all of them, each and every one of them, they believe in God, individually and collectively. Kullun amana billah, wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusuli. You would see that when the hadith of Jibril that was talking about the religion is very similar to this, but Allah added a few things that were not in that hadith. It says, wal malaika, they believe in the angels. Wa kutubihi wa rusuli, they believe in the books and the messengers. It says, la nufarriku bayna ahadin min rusul. This is the nas of the Quran, that no one should distinguish between each prophet. We should not make distinction between one prophet being more meritorious than the other one. لَا نُفَرِّكُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِنْ رُسُلٍ وَقَالُوا سَمِئْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. The first quality you find with the believers is سَمِئْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. They would hear the message and they would process it and they would follow it. So you see that Allah says لَا نُفَرِّكُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِنْ رُسُلٍ. They make no distinction between any of the messengers. They don't say that one is better than the other one. They don't say that one is less than the other one. وَقَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعْطَانَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا. Aside the fact that they listen, they follow غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا, and they make an appeal to Allah that, oh Allah, grant us your forgiveness. وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ, because to Allah is the returning of our journey. The life that we came to is a journey, and we're going to transit back to where we came from. Then also in Surah Al-Imran, Quran chapter 3, verse 28, Allah says, لَا تَتَّخِذُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَا مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ فَلَيْسَ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِي شَيْءٍ إِلَّا أَنْ تَتَّقُوا مِنْهُمْ تُقَاتُ وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَ وَإِلَى اللَّهِ الْمَصِيرُ. In the event of learning to know the qualities and the characters of the believer, no one can better explain them to us except Allah, Azza wa Jalla, who created us. And he's the one that knows the intent of why he wants us to be exemplary examples. He says, لَا تَتَّخِذُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاهَ مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That let no believer take the disbeliever as protectors apart from the believers. So we should have confidence in the believers, seek protection from the believers, take them as our awliya, our intimate protectors. He says, then Allah says, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَلَيْسَ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِي شَيْءٍ, that whoever does this, whosoever does that, has no bond with Allah Azza wa Jalla. إِلَّا أَن تَتَّكُوا مِنْهُ التُّقَاتِ وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَ وَإِلَى اللَّهِ الْمَصِيرُ. Unless you guard against them out of prudence and God wants you of himself and unto Allah is the return. You would see that those two ayahs that I quote before, one says, wa ilayka al-masir, this one says, wa ilallahi al-masir. Our journey would give account of everything that we're doing. Also in Surah Al-Ali Imran, Quran chapter 3, verse 110, Allah says, kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah walau amana ahla al-kitab lakana khayran lahum min umul mu'minun wa aktharuhum fasiqun. Allah says, kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Indeed, surely you are the best community brought forth unto mankind. Why are we the best community if we are mu'minin? Allah says, because ta'muruna bil ma'ruf, because we command and we enjoy goodness and we are also on the goodness. We don't command goodness, we don't enjoy goodness and not be a part of it. And we forbid evil and we forbid wrong and we're not a part of evil. وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ and we maintain our belief in Allah. Allah says, وَلَوْ آمَنَ أَعْلَى الْكِتَابِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ and were the people of the book to believe in this same message, it would have been better for them. Allah says, مِنِهُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَأَكْثَرُهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ amongst them, you will find those that are true believers, but many of them are iniquitous to the message that was sent by Allah Azza wa Jalla. We will journey also in the qualities of what a believer should be. In Quran chapter 8, verse 2 to 4, Surah Al-Anfal, Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرَ اللَّهِ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آياته زادت إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. الله أكبر. Allah says, إنما المؤمنون. Only they are the believers. إذا ذكر الله. When the words of Allah is rehearsed to them. وجلت قلوبهم. Their hearts quake. Their hearts tremor with the words of Allah, with the fear of Allah. وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. And when the words of Allah are rehearsed to them, when the signs of Allah are recited to them, زادتهم إيمانا, they would increase in faith. They had faith initially, but that faith will be elevated. وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. And they have no reliance on any other thing but on Allah. Allah is their source of trust and reliance. So a believer will trust Allah alone, rely on him, and they will increase in faith each time they hear the message. And they will be quick to want to implement the message as Allah has legislated. Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُكِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ in verse number 3 of Quran chapter 8, Surah Al-Anfal. الَّذِينَ يُكِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ the qualities of a believer, الَّذِينَ يُكِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ they always perform the prayer. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ and they spend of which we have provided for them of resources. So they spend their money, they spend their time, and we'll learn about what they spend, inshallah, shortly. Then Allah said in verse number 4, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ إِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ may Allah count us among those that will be meritorious of such qualities. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ indeed, they are the true believers. لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ إِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ for them are ranks in the sight of their Lord. Allah has elevated them in status, in ranks, for the reward that he has for them. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ Allah would also accompany that elevation of status with his forgiveness. وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ and Allah has a generous provision for them, both in this world and on the day of judgment. May Allah count us among them. Ameen. Also in Corinthians chapter 8, verse 74, we're learning the qualities of a believer. Allah said, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَهَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آوَوا وَنَصَرُوا أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. Allah Akbar. You see that the first two verses I quoted, they had something that had to do with the return is to Allah. You find that these two verses I'm quoting now, they are also saying, وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. Allah has a generous provision for the believer. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, and those who believe, وَهَاجَرُوا, and they migrate for the sake of Allah. They leave the sin for what will lead them to prosperity. They leave the sin for virtuous characters, for manners that will be meritorious of Allah's bounty. Wahajaru, like the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi left Mecca for Medina. And those that went with him, they did hijrah. Wajahadu fi sabilillah. And they strive in the ways of Allah. So to strive in the ways of Allah with many, many things. وَالَّذِينَ آوَوا وَنَصَرُوا أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ حَقًّا. Aside the fact that they strived in the ways of Allah, and those who sheltered and helped also by staying behind, it is they that truly are the believers. And Allah says, لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. Theirs will be the reward of forgiveness and a generous provision. Allah is wanting us to understand that a believer to another believer is a peace. Allah says in Quran chapter 9, verse 71, Surah At-Tawbah, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْدٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْعَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah says, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ, and the believing men and believing women, بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْدٍ, they are but a protector and a support for one another. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, they both enjoin what is good. وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and collectively they forbid what is wrong. وَيُكِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ, they abode in performance of salah. وَيُوتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ, and they also give from the charity or the alms from what Allah has provided for them. وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and they are always obeying Allah and the Prophet. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ, on them, they are those upon whom سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ, Allah's mercy would descend upon them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ, Allah is truly mighty with what he does and he is wise on how he legislates on us. So you will find that a believer is a support system for another believer. They would encourage them on goodness and they will forbid them from evil. And they would also engage in prayers together with other believers. They will pray for other believers in their presence and in their absence. And they would give to those that are in need, even before they ask. And even when they ask and they don't have, they find a way of delivering this need with dignity and respect. Allah Akbar. Allah says, on these people, they are those that would earn the mercy of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. May Allah count us of those that would earn his mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah's might, he will use it with them, which is way that he would bless them. And through his wisdom, he would elevate the status of the believers. Also in Surah At-Tawbah, Quran chapter 9, verse 105, Allah says, وَكُلْ يَعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ أَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَسَتُرَدُّونَ إِلَى عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. A believer is someone, Allah said to Prophet, وَكُلِ عِمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ, that tell them that they should be up and doing. They should perform their deeds. A believer is not complacent. A believer is always active on positivity. That God sees their deeds. And he will, and so will the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. God sees the deeds as well as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the believers, they see the deeds of those that are doing good. And we shall be brought to account to know of what we have done, of the seen and the unseen, because Allah is Alim al-Ghaib wa Shahada. Allah will bring us to account because he will bring back everything based on the knowledge of what people have known about us and what they don't know about us, because he's the one that sees everything about us and nothing is hidden from him. And he will inform you of everything that you used to do, that I used to do, that we all used to do. Allah will give us a detailed analysis of how we used to engage in with him. So the believers, they have what they call sincerity of purpose and accountability. So they're always taking inventory of their sins and their mistakes and striving to be better persons or better people by not consistently making excuses. We also learn from this ayah the lesson of time management and productivity. So we have to know that when Allah is saying, وَقُلْ إِيَمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ أَمَلَكُمْ, be up and doing, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, tell them, a Muslim is up and doing. A believer is always engaging in something positive. They're making impacts. Allah is telling us that we should be up and doing. وَأَمَلَكُمْ, and our deeds Allah knows. وَرَسُولُهُ, he knows. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ, and also the believers around us, they see those that are impacting goodness. وَسَتُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ, and you should know that whether you do it well or not, we'd all return to Allah. فَوَنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and he'll give us a glad tidings, or he'll give us the detail of what we used to do. So we learn also in Quran chapter 24, verse 30 and 31, Surah An-Nur, the quality of a believer. Allah says, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُدُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَذُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ ذَلِكَ أَذْكَى لَهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, قُلْ, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell the believing men, لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُدُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ, tell them to lower their gazes, to lower their eyes when they are in the sight of other people that are not their mahram. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ, and to protect their private parts from all kinds of impurity. ذَلِكَ أَذْكَى لَهُمْ, this is purer for them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ, إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah says, indeed, he is aware of whatever we do. Then Allah continued on verse number 31, and I will only read a fraction of verse number 31 because of time. He says, وَكُلِّ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغُدُّدْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَلِيَذْرِبْنَ بِخُمُورِهِنَّ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنَّ وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا لِبُهُولَاتِهِنَّ أَوْ آبَائِهِنَّ, إِلَى آخِرِ آيَاتِ. It says, كُلِّ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ, tell the believing women, يَغْدُدْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ, that tell them that they should also lower their gazes, وَيَحْفَظُ فُرُوجَهُنَّ, and they should also protect their private parts, وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ, and they should not display their adornment, إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, except what is visible of it. And a lot of scholars, they translate إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, that the face, the hands, you know, some scholars differ whether the feet is included in that. So, إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, then it says, وليضربن بخمورهن على جيوبهن. And they should also use their veil to cover their bosoms or their breasts. They should not expose themselves to people to know how Allah has created them. ولا يبدين زينتهن إلا لبهولاتهن أو آبائهن. And they should not display their adornment except to their husbands or to their fathers. And you can read more about that in Quran chapter 24, verse 31, all the way to the end. You would see that at the end of the ayah, Allah once again stomping for women as well, not to stomp their feet on the ground as they are walking, in a way whereby they will reveal some of their parts of their body that have been concealed in the clothes as well, by strutting and exposing themselves the way they stomp. The same men should also not stomp. He says, Ibadur Rahman, will come to what Allah said about Ibadur Rahman. You see that Surah Luqman, it says, Waqsid fi mashik waqdud min sawtik inna ankara al-aswat la sawt al-hamir. So waqsid fi mashik, when you walk in a pendulous stride, don't be too much in a hurry and don't drag. Be calculating. Walk brisk and walk smart. Waqdud min sawtik, whenever you speak, don't be of that person that is always raising their voice. Inna ankara al-aswat la sawt al-hamir. So the believers do not scream, they do not shout. The verse that I'm going to also talk about, that talks about the qualities of the believer in Surah Al-Hujurat, that's Quran chapter 49, verses 10, when Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَسْلِهُ بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَأَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. The believers are but brothers to one another. So make peace between yourselves as brethren and reverence Allah so that you may receive mercy. See, these words, if we take it to action, the problems that Muslims are facing around the world will not face it. So the believers are like a single structured body, each part supporting the other. The centrality of brotherly love in Islam may be best expressed in the famous hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, says, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you truly believe except and until you love for your brother what you love for yourself. We should not make alliances based on mere tribal bonds. Bonds of faith are esteemed so highly in Islam that among the seven types of people whom Allah Azza wa Jalla said he will grant paradise on the day of judgment, he lists two men who love each other for the sake of God, meeting for his sake and parting for his sake, nothing but for the love of Allah. God will ask them on that day of judgment that, where are those people that used to love each other for the sake of my glory? Today, on the day where there is no shade but mine, I shall shade them under my shade. يَوْمَ لَا ذِلَّ إِلَّا ذِلُّهُ. There will be no shade on that day except the shade of Allah. And there are seven categories of people. I know the Imam would have talked about this and would have heard about it many times, inshallah. So the other verse that I will quote before I come to a conclusion to allow for questioning is Quran chapter 49, verse 15. And it says, إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون. For you to be a true believer, you will have all these qualities that Allah is about to tell us. He says, إنما المؤمنون, indeed the believers, الذين آمنوا, they are those that have the belief in Allah. وَرَسُولِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ, they believe in Allah and the Prophet. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. So it says, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا, they don't doubt their belief system. They are never in doubt. You know, today we have a lot of Muslims that are living in doubt. They question a lot of the tenets. They question the authenticity of many things in the religion without being specific. And Allah is saying that Lam Yartabu, they have unshakable faith. Their faith is very firm. وَجَاهَدُوا فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ They strive with their wealth and themselves in the ways of Allah. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ These are the truthful ones. They are steadfast. Their steadfastness brings about a true faith in us. Spending our money, spending our time, spending our expertise, spending our knowledge, all these will bring about that steadfastness that will give us everything, that we're willing to give up everything for the sake of Allah to earn Allah's pleasure. May Allah count us of those that would earn His pleasure. So you would think that when I was given this topic, maybe I will only touch on one of the verses that is very common that people would quote when it comes to the qualities of the believer. But we would not leave this topic except that we touch the words of Allah in Surah Al-Furqan. And my conclusion, as Allah is telling us in Surah Al-Furqan, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah says, وَإِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَ أُمَّ الْجَائِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا Indeed, the true servants of Allah, الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا When they walk on earth, they walk upon the earth modestly. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَ أُمَّ الْجَائِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا And when fools address them foolishly, they extend peace unto them. Then Allah says, well, that's Quran chapter 25, verses 63. I'm going to go 63, inshallah, or 63 to 77 as my time permits. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا They are those that spend their night in prostration to Allah. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ They are always in constant remembrance of Allah. سُجَّدًا by prostrating to him, وَقِيَامًا and standing up for him. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمَ إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا They are constantly remembering Allah and beseeching him to save them from the doom of the hellfire. They used to say, رَبَّنَا O Allah, اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمَ Save us from the doom of the day of hellfire and the hell. Inna adhabaha kana gharama. Indeed, the punishment of the hellfire is something that is unbearable. Innaha sa'at mustaqarran wa muqama. That the time will come and nothing will change it. Walladhina idha anfaku. The qualities of believers, number four. Idha anfaku, when they spend, lam yusrifu. They are not wasteful. Walam yakhturu. They are not miserly. Wa kana bayna dhalika qawama. They maintain a balance in their spending. They do what they call due diligence of spending. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَا يَزْنُونَ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَى أَثَامًا Allah is telling us in Quran chapter 25 verse number 68. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ They don't call on any other God. They don't associate any partners with Allah. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَا يَزْنُونَ And they don't kill any soul. They don't abort babies that they don't want. They don't engage in things that will bring about babies that will lead to abortion. Wala yaznun. And they are not known for fornication or adultery. So they maintain the nature. In their nature, you find that they don't take the soul unjustly, neither do they commit adultery or fornication. ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما. Whoever engages in this is engaging in a sin. Allah says يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا. For, may Allah save us from this kind of punishment. Allah says يضاعف له العذاب. Allah would multiply for them their punishment on the day of judgment for people that are always constantly doing this and not repenting. Allah says إلا من تاب, except that they repent. You know, we are all full of sins. We've all done things that we're not proud of. Illa man taba. Allah says that they are quick to seek repentance. Wa amana, and they believe in Allah. Wa amila amalan saliha, they engage in actions that are good. Fa ulaika yubaddilu Allahu sayyi'atihim hasanat. Then Allah will change their bad actions to good. Inna al-hasanat yudhibna sayyi'at, dhalika dhikra lil-dhakirin. That it is only the multiplication of good deeds and the reward of that good deeds that will wipe away the bad record that we have. Dhalika dhikra lil-dhakirin. These are indeed reminders for the one that wants to benefit from the remembrance. Allah says that illa man taba wa amana wa amila amalan salih fa ulaika yubaddilu Allahu sayyi'atihim hasanat. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. They are quick to seek repentance from Allah, and they own up when they are wrong, and they are motivated to do the righteous deeds so as to change their evil deeds to good deeds. Allah is saying that on them, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا, Allah would forgive them and will bless them. May Allah count us of those that He will bless and forgive. Allah says, والذين لا يشهدون الزور وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما. Another quality of a believer is that they don't bear false testimony. والذين إذا ذكر والذين لا يشهدون الزور. They are not false witnesses, nor do they bear false evidences. وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما. When they observe idle talk being in their presence, what they do is that they pass by with dignity. They don't engage in backbiting. They don't engage in character assassination. They don't engage in persecution. They are those that the believers, they are those that what? Alladhina idha dhukira Allah. He says, walladhina la yashaduna dhu. When they are given the opportunity to bear witness, they bear true witnesses. They don't connive and concord things to implicate someone. La yashaduna zur wa iza marru bil lagwi. And when idle talks are being rehearsed behind them, see, they don't engage in the lagu marru kirama. They live with dignity. Allah says, walladhina idha dhukra, walladhina idha dhukiru bi ayati rabbihim. لَمْ يَخِرُّ عَلَيْهِمْ سُمَّا وَأُمْيَانًا. He says, وَإِذَا is وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرُ اللَّهِ وَإِلَىٰ إِذَا ذُكِرُ اللَّهِ. When Allah, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. When they are rehearsed and they are reminded of the words of their Lord. When they hear the words of their Lord, what do they do? لَمْ يَخِرُّ عَلَيْهِمْ سُمَّا وَأُمْيَانًا. They don't turn a deaf ears or a blind face to the words of Allah. They pay close attention to the words of Allah. They don't turn a deaf ears and face to the words of Allah. They pay close attention to the words of Allah, and they are willing to change instantly. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. They are those that constantly they pray to Allah to make of their wives and their children comfort of their eyes and their hearts, and make them pious leaders amongst mankind. Ulaika yujizawna al-ghurfata bima sabaru wa yulaqawna fiha ta'iyyatan wa salama. Allah says, they exhibit the patience and the steadfastness in all situations. Allah will grant them peace in this world, and He will grant them peace when they meet Him. Ulaika yujizawna al-ghurfata bima sabaru. Al-ghurfa is a room. But they will have different rooms in paradise, inshallah. Bima sabaru, because of the patience that they exercised by not following in the things that may seem fun, but will bring about sin. They are different. They are unique. They stand out because they are known for qualities that are good. Bima sabaru, they were patient. They could have easily fallen victims like you and I. Allah says, وَيُلَقَوْنَ فِيهَا تَحِيَّةً وَسَلَامًا, and Allah will meet them with his peace. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will be in that place of peace, Darul Salam. May Allah count us of those that will be in Darul Salam in Jannah. حَسُنَتْ مُسْتَقَرًا وَمُقَامًا, what a great reward will be for them. Allah says, كُلْ مَا يَبَاهُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ فَقَدْ كَذَّبْتُمْ فَسَوْفَ يَكُونُ لِزَامًا. Our prayers are always answered by Allah. As believers, we should have certainty of faith that Allah is always answering our prayers. Whatever I've said that is not so accurate is due to my limited knowledge. Whatever I've said that is good is from Allah and His Prophet. May Allah forgive each and every one of us. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam. Jazakumullahu khairan. What a beautiful delivery. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you for this effort. Ameen. Yeah.